Hashtag Right Start is the new initiative that is being started by the Early Childhood Association. We are starting this to educate parents on how to choose the right preschool for their child. Early Childhood Association partners with First Moms Club, Unimo and Baby Chakra, all Facebook moms groups, to bring to you the perfect way to choose the right school for your child. The preschool years are the most important in a child's life. But many parents are not aware of the importance of these years. The kind of school, the kind of teacher that your child gets in these years will make your child's personality, will make your child's learning style, and will make your child's character. So it's very important that you choose wisely and you understand what to look for when you are choosing the school. So Right Start is what we are campaigning for. Hashtag Right Start. So the 10 things that the Early Childhood Association wants every parent to look for when they go for admission for the first time for their preschooler are these. Number one, please do not enroll your child before the age of 3 in a nursery class. The right age for a nursery class child is 3 years. So there is a class before nursery which is called play school, that is 2 years. But if your child is being admitted in the nursery, your child should be 3 years. Don't try to save 1 year of your child. Please remember, the older the child in a class, the better the performance. So the child should be 3 years in nursery, 4 years in junior KG, 5 years in senior KG, and 6 years when your child comes to grade one. So insist that your child should be 3 years when your child joins the nursery class. Any school that tells you otherwise is not worth it. Point number two, many parents ask which board should we choose when we are choosing the school for our child. Well, every board has its plus points and has its negatives. So choosing a board is not important. What's important is choosing the school based on its reputation and choosing who's leading the school, the principal, the head of the school. How parent-centric is that school? How child-centric is the curriculum? Choose that. The board ultimately is all about what your child will learn in different subjects. So I would say, look at the principal, look at who heads the school. So it's very important that you don't only focus on the board. Number three, many parents talk about fees. This school has such high fees. This school has such low fees. I don't think it's fees that you should look at. You should look at if the school has very high fees, then what is it that the school is promising to you for these high fees? Ask them that. And then ensure that the school delivers on those promises. If the school has very low fees, that's also not very good. Because ask them, where are they cutting the corners? Because low fees means two things. Either the teacher's salaries are low, or the kind of equipment and material your child will lose will not be up to that mark. So when it comes to fees, it's not about high or low. It's about whether you are getting your money's worth. That should be more important. The Early Childhood Association feels that the fourth point that you should look for in a school when you are choosing one for your preschooler is the qualifications of the teachers. Are they qualified in early childhood education? Because if the teachers have not done any course, if they are not qualified to understand about early childhood, then how are they going to take care of your children and the needs that come in the early years? In the early years, children have tantrums. In the early years, children have fears. If the teacher is not qualified, she will not be able to understand your child and may end up labeling your child, which may go against your child for life. So do look into qualifications. Number five, background verification. Insist to choose a school that believes in doing the background verification of its staff. Because today, safety has become paramount when we are doing anything for our children. Point number six that you should look into and ask for is the discipline policy of the school. Do they believe in shouting at children? Do they believe in hitting children? How will my child be disciplined in the school? A discipline policy is a must. Ensure that the school makes their teachers and other staff sign a zero tolerance policy. A zero tolerance policy defines what not to do with children, and that the school will take a stand that if something harmful is done to any child, they will remove the staff. That is called a zero tolerance policy. So a discipline policy is a must. Most importantly, point is your child going to be interviewed for admission? Now, I find this very funny. If you are a good school, then you should be able to take all kinds of children. You should be able to make children better learners, better individuals. But maybe these schools don't have that confidence, and that's why they interview children and want to take only the best. Well, that itself tells you that if a school is interviewing, it doesn't have the confidence in its own abilities. And think of the torture and stress your children go through when a stranger interviews them. Do you really think a child as young as that should be interviewed? Then avoid such schools. They are an absolute no-no. I also know of schools that interview parents. For what? India has an act called the Right to Education. You have a right to enroll your child in a school. Why should a school interview you or the child? It should be completely on first term, first basis. So don't go for schools that interview your child. Most importantly, again, something that we overlook in our selection of school is the distance from home. Our children are spending too much time in the school bus. They are getting bullied in the school bus. They learn to be, you know, free all the time, doing nothing. They get bored. They then end up doing all kinds of wrong activities in the bus. Their spine suffers, their back suffers. It's not good. Choose a school that has the minimalistic distance from your home. Or choose a school in which your child may not spend more than half an hour traveling by bus. Because anything more than that for that little baby is not worth it. Most important point while choosing your child's preschool, give that school your five senses test. Yes, you heard it right. Five senses test. So, number one, hears. Try to hear the sounds in the school. Are they only of adults talking, shouting, screaming? Or are you also hearing sounds of children giggling, laughing, talking? Then that's a good school. Sight. Look around you. Don't only look at the ambience and the air condition and all. Look at the work displayed. Is it more children's work? And is that children's work more child-directed work? If it's only worksheets, it means the school is going to stress out your child. But if it's a mix of drawings, worksheets, paintings, it means your child is going to get the right foundation. Smell. Try to visit their toilets and try to take a smell. How bad are the toilets smelling? Because children at that young age, if they stop going to the toilet because of bad smell, you are gifting your child kidney problems, because children will stop drinking water because they don't want to go to that toilet. So it's very important you give it the smell test. So you have your sight, your hearing, your smell. Mouth. Ask questions to the person who's giving you the interview. Ask questions about the school, as I told you about the policies, about the CCTV cameras. Ask them about these things, because it's very important that you ask questions more rather than being asked more. And the last is touch. As you go around the school, try to touch the edges. Are they sharp? Then they're going to hurt your child. Try to touch surfaces. Are they dusty? It means the school is not very focused on its cleanliness. And most and very important, look around for CCTV cameras. Are they there in specific locations where it's required? The only place where a CCTV camera is not required is inside a toilet booth. But otherwise, even the toilet block, which means the entry to the toilets, need to have a CCTV camera. So when you are asking, ask about who monitors these CCTV cameras. How often are they monitored? And most importantly, how long do they keep the backup of the recordings? Ideally, every school should keep for about 3 months to 6 months. And last, about CCTV cameras, which I know a lot of parents want, but which is actually bad. Live streaming on your mobile phones. It is absolutely wrong if a school is ready to live stream a classroom on your mobile phone. Because think of what's happening. When the preschool live streams a whole class to you on your mobile phone and to every parent, I, as a parent, am getting the live streaming of other children also. Today, if there is a predator, today is there is an abuser, I can watch the habits of all these children and it makes them easy victims for kidnapping, etc. Because your phone can get hacked. Somebody, an uncle, a friend can use your phone and watch all this. Do you really think that you should be giving away the privacy of children like that? Live streaming is nothing but helicopter parenting. So it's very important that if you don't trust the school, don't take an admission there. If you still feel that you want to watch your child, go to the school, ask them to allow you to sit outside the class and watch your child. But live streaming is a complete no-no. Early Childhood Association would want you to keep all these points in mind when you are choosing the preschool for your child. Please remember that choosing the right preschool is giving your child the right start for life. Let's remember what Maria Montessori said. She said it's not the age of university studies which is important. It is the age between the years of birth to 6 years. So when you are choosing your child's preschool, you are actually choosing your child's foundation for life. Please give your child a right start and please spread this message to as many parents as possible on the 10 pointers by the Early Childhood Association of how to choose the right preschool for your child. Join us on Right Start.